Chapter 19. Mary. In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful. Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain, Saad. This is a mention of the mercy of your Lord to his slave Zechariah, when he called out to his Lord a call in secret, saying, My Lord, indeed my bones have grown feeble, and grey hair has spread on my head, and I have never been unblessed in my invocation to you, O my Lord. And indeed, I fear for my relatives after me, since my wife is barren. So give me from yourself an heir, who shall inherit from me, and also inherit religious knowledge, and the prophethood of Jacob. And make him my Lord, one with whom you are well pleased. Allah said, O Zechariah, indeed we give you glad tidings of a son. His name will be John. We have given that name to none before him. He said, My Lord, how can I have a son when my wife is barren and I have reached extreme old age? Allah said, So it will be. Your Lord says, It is easy for me. Certainly I have created you before when you were but nothing. Zechariah said, My Lord, appoint for me a sign. He said, Your sign is that you shall not speak to mankind for 3 nights, though having no bodily defect. Then he came out to his people from his chamber. He told them by signs to glorify Allah's praises in the morning and in the afternoon. It was said to his son, O John, hold fast to the scripture, the Torah. And we gave him wisdom while he was yet a child, and made him compassionate to men as a mercy from us, and pure from sins. And he was righteous and dutiful towards his parents, and he was neither arrogant nor disobedient to Allah or to his parents. And peace be upon him the day he was born, the day he dies, and the day he will be raised up to life again. And mention in the book this Quran, O Muhammad, the story of Mary, when she withdrew in seclusion from her family to a place facing east. She placed a barrier to screen herself from them. Then we sent to her our angel Gabriel, and he appeared before her in the form of a man in all respects. She said, Indeed, I seek refuge in the Most Gracious Allah from you, if you fear Allah. The angel said, I am only a messenger from your Lord, to announce to you the gift of a righteous son. She said, How can I have a son, when no man has touched me, and I am not unchaste? He said, So it will be. Your Lord said, This is easy for me, and we wish to appoint him as a sign to mankind and a mercy from us. This is a predestined matter. So she conceived him, and she withdrew with him to a far place. And the pains of childbirth drove her to the trunk of a date palm. She said, Would that I had died before this, and had been forgotten and out of sight. Then a voice cried to her from below her, saying, Do not grieve. Your Lord has provided a water stream under you. And shake the trunk of the date palm toward you, and fresh ripe dates will fall to you. So eat and drink and be glad, and if you see any human being, say, Indeed, I have made a vow of silence to the Most Gracious Allah, so I shall not speak to any human being this day. Then she brought the baby to her people, carrying him. They said, O Mary, indeed you have brought a thing unheard of and mighty. O sister of Aaron, your father was not a man who used to commit adultery, nor was your mother an unchaste woman. Then she pointed to him. They said, How can we talk to one who is a child in a cradle? Jesus said, Indeed, I am a slave of Allah. He has given me the scripture, and made me a prophet, and has made me blessed wherever I may be, and has enjoined on me prayer and charity as long as I live. I am to honor my mother, and he did not make me arrogant and rebellious. And peace be upon me the day I was born, and the day I die, and the day I shall be raised alive. Such is Jesus, son of Mary. It is a statement of truth about which they doubt. It does not befit the majesty of Allah that he should have a son. Glorified and exalted be he above all that they associate with him. When he decrees a thing, he only says to it, Be, and it is. Jesus said, "And indeed Allah is my Lord and your Lord, so worship him alone. That is the straight path." Then the sects differed amongst themselves. So woe to the disbelievers who gave false witness by saying that Jesus is the Son of Allah, from the meeting of a great day when they will be thrown into the blazing fire. How clearly will the polytheists and disbelievers in the oneness of Allah see and hear on the day when they will appear before us? But the polytheists and wrongdoers today are in plain error. And warn them, O Muhammad, of the day of grief and regret when judgment will be issued, as now they are in a state of carelessness and they do not believe. Indeed, we will inherit the earth and whatever is on it, and to us they shall all be returned. And mention in the book, the Quran, Abraham. Indeed, he was a man of truth, a prophet, when he said to his father, "O my father, why do you worship that which does not hear, does not see, and cannot help you in any way? O my father, indeed, there has come to me knowledge which did not come to you, so follow me, I will guide you to a straight path. O my father, do not worship Satan. Indeed, Satan has rebelled against the most gracious Allah. O my father, indeed I fear in case a torment from the most gracious Allah overtake you, so that you become a companion of Satan in the hellfire." His father said, "Do you reject my gods, O Abraham? If you do not stop, I will indeed stone you. So get away from me safely before I punish you." Abraham said, "Peace be upon you. I will ask forgiveness of my Lord for you. Indeed, he is to me ever most gracious. And I shall turn away from you and from those whom you invoke besides Allah. And I shall call on my Lord, and I hope that I shall not be unblessed in my invocation to my Lord." So when he turned away from them and from those whom they worship besides Allah, we gave him Isaac and Jacob, and both of them we made a prophet. And we gave them of our mercy a good provision in plenty, and we granted them honor on the tongues of all the nations, all remember them with a good praise. And mention in the book this Quran, Moses. Indeed, he was chosen, and he was a messenger and a prophet. And we called him from the right side of the mount, and made him draw near to us for a talk with him. And we bestowed on him his brother Aaron, also a prophet, out of our mercy. And mention in the book this Quran, Ishmael. Indeed, he was true to what he promised, and he was a messenger and a prophet. And he used to enjoin on his family and his people prayer and charity, and his Lord was pleased with him. And mention in the book this Quran, Enoch. Indeed, he was a man of truth and a prophet, and we raised him to a high station. They were those on whom Allah bestowed his grace from among the prophets, of the offspring of Adam, and of those whom we carried in the ship with Noah, and of the offspring of Abraham and Israel, and from among those whom we guided and chose. When the verses of the most gracious Allah were recited to them, they fell down prostrating and weeping. Then there have succeeded them generations who have given up prayer and made their prayers to be lost, by not offering them, or by not offering them perfectly, or by not offering them in their proper fixed times, and they have followed lusts. So they will be thrown into hell, except those who repent and believe in the oneness of Allah and his messenger Muhammad, and work righteousness. Such will enter paradise, and they will not be wronged in aught. They will enter gardens of eternity in paradise, which the most gracious Allah has promised to those who worship him, even in privacy. Indeed, his promise must come to pass. They shall not hear in paradise any false, evil, or vain talk, but only salutations of peace, and they will have sustenance morning and afternoon. Such is the paradise which we shall give as an inheritance to those of our slaves who have been amongst the pious and righteous persons. And the angels do not descend except by the command of your Lord, O Muhammad. To him belongs what is before us and what is behind us, and what is between those two, and your Lord is never forgetful, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, and all that is between them. So worship him alone and be constant and patient in his worship. Do you know of any who is similar to him? Of course, none is similar or comparable to him, and he has none as a partner with him. There is nothing like him, and he is the all-hearer, the all-seer. And man says, When I am dead, shall I then be raised up alive? Does man not remember that we created him before when he was nothing? So by your Lord, surely, we shall gather them together and also the devil with them. Then we shall bring them to hell on their knees. Then indeed we shall drag out from every sect all those who were worst in obstinate rebellion against the most gracious Allah. Then indeed we know best those who are most worthy of being burnt there. There is not one of you who will not pass over hell. This is with your Lord, a decree which must be accomplished. Then we shall save those who used to fear Allah and were dutiful to him. And we shall leave the polytheists and wrongdoers humbled on their knees in hell. And when our clear verses are recited to them, those who disbelieve from amongst the rich and strong, from amongst the pagans of Quraysh who live a life of luxury, say to those who believe amongst the weak, poor companions of the Prophet Muhammad who have a hard life, which of the two groups, believers and disbelievers, is best in position and as regards station? And how many a generation have we destroyed before them, who were better in wealth, goods, and outward appearance? Say, O Muhammad, whoever is in error, the most gracious Allah will extend the rope to him, until, when they see that which they were promised, either the torment or the hour, they will come to know who is worst in position and who is weaker in forces. And Allah increases in guidance those who walk aright from amongst the true believers in the oneness of Allah, who fear Allah much, and abstain from all kinds of sins and evil deeds which He has forbidden, and love Allah much by performing all kinds of good deeds which He has ordained. And the righteous good deeds that last are better with your Lord for reward and better for resort. Have you noted the one who disbelieved in our proofs, signs, and revelations, and yet says, I shall certainly be given wealth and children? Has he seen the future? Or has he taken a covenant from the most gracious Allah? No. We shall record what he says, and we shall increase his torment in hell. And we shall inherit from him at his death all that he talks of regarding wealth and children which we have bestowed upon him in this world, and he shall come to us alone. And they have taken for worship gods besides Allah, that they might give them honor, power, and glory, and also protect them from Allah's punishment. No, but their so-called gods will deny their worship of them, and become opponents to them on the day of resurrection. Do you not see that we have sent the devils against the disbelievers to push them to do evil? So do not hasten against them. We only count out to them a limited number of days of the life of this world, and delay their term, so that they may increase in evil and sins. The day will come when we will gather the pious to the most gracious Allah, like a delegate presented before a king for honor. And we shall drive the polytheists, sinners, criminals, and disbelievers in the oneness of Allah to hell, in a thirsty state like a thirsty herd driven down to water. None shall have the power of intercession except one who has received permission from the most gracious Allah. And they say, The most gracious Allah has begotten a son. Indeed, you have said a terrible evil thing, whereby the heavens are almost torn, and the earth is split asunder, and the mountains fall in ruins. They ascribe a son to the most gracious Allah. But it is not befitting for the majesty of the most gracious Allah that he should beget a son. There is none in the heavens and the earth, but they come to the most gracious Allah as a slave. Indeed, he has encompassed them, and has counted them one by one. And every one of them will come to him alone on the day of resurrection, without any helper, protector, or defender. Indeed, those who believe in the oneness of Allah and in His Messenger Muhammad, and work deeds of righteousness, the Most Gracious Allah will bestow love for them in the hearts of the believers. So, we have made this Quran easy in your own tongue, O Muhammad, only so that you may give glad tidings to the pious and righteous people, and warn with it the most quarrelsome of people.
And how many a generation before them have we destroyed? Canst thou, Muhammad, see a single man of them, or hear from them the slightest sound?
Please subscribe to our channel. Kindly like, share, and comment on our videos. If anyone benefits because of your like and share, then God may provide you with unlimited reward, which is called Sadaqatul Jariyah in Islam. Sadaqatul Jariyah is continuous rewards received for good actions, deeds, and spreading knowledge. It is a gift that not only benefits us in this life, but also benefits us and our loved ones in the hereafter, according to the hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, narrated by Muslim. When a person dies, all the deeds end except three: a continuing charity, beneficial knowledge, and a child who prays for them.